DBN Nation, of course. Support DBN Nation. You're hearing it from Floyd Money Mayweather. What's going on?
This is Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder.
My name is Gennady Golovkin.
And you're watching Dante's Boxing Nation.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Dante's Boxing Nation. This is AK / IKEA reporting. If you're trying to get smarter by the minute, subscribe below. If you're trying to get dumber by the second, don't listen to these casual-ass fans. But before we get a rolling, I just want to say a little side note. Dante gave me the opportunity to post on his platform every now and then to share my thoughts and opinion. So I just want to get that cleared. And if you want to subscribe to my channel, that will be in the description box below. But while you're at it, show love and support to Dante's Cooking Nation and also Dante's Travel Nation. But let's get straight to it. So the Nevada Commission came out and stated that both Conor McGregor and Khabib will be suspended for 10 days for the brawl they caused after the fight. And no further information will be revealed because they started an investigation on the brawl, etc., etc. Now, Conor McGregor, on the other hand, can't fight for a whole month. He got suspended for a whole month that he's not allowed to fight because of the ass whooping he received from Khabib. So, I mean, I don't know what's the purpose of this suspension. He won't fight in a month anyways. He most likely be chilling or on a vacay anyways. And you also think that there's no purpose for the 10-day suspension for Conor and Khabib, because 10 days, what's that really gonna do? However, you know, the commission have to save face and they have to kind of act like they did something to somebody so other fighters won't feel like it's okay to do something like that without a price to pay. And speaking of prices, they will fine both Conor and Khabib because both fighters did something wrong after the fight. Khabib, on one hand, he jumped the whole team. Conor McGregor, on the other hand, he hit, I think, the coach of Khabib, and then he got beat up in the process. So both fighters will be fine. However, Dana White came out and finally stated that Khabib will not be stripped of his title. Absolutely not. So that's good information. But even if you think that it was wrong or right for Khabib to do what he did after the fight, at the end of the day, he got called a Muslim fucking rat right after he just knocked out Conor McGregor or choked him or the neck crank or whatever. He just did what he had to do to Conor. He got called all type of names that disrespected not just him, but his religion. Somewhere you're not supposed to go. That sparked something in him. And he felt like he needed to jump the whole team, which he did on some gangster shit, like I said before. So do I blame him for that? Absolutely not. If I got offended, I know 100% he got offended. And if the adrenaline running where now I'm gonna stop him at the moment, then so be it. Conor McGregor, that's what they asked for. They were talking trash. They called him out. They talking about you're a Muslim fucking rat, blah, blah, blah. They went to places they weren't supposed to go because they not offending Khabib personally. They offending everybody that's a Muslim. They offending the people that are Muslim. They taking shots at their religion. You don't do that. That's something you don't cross. So like I said, if he felt the need of doing what he did, and I'm pretty sure he thought it was wrong after he did it, because you're supposed to just to leave it in the ring or in the octagon, not outside of the octagon. But like I said, he did what he had to do. And at the end of the day, he came on top. So don't promote the UFC build up on how Conor trying to be tough when he went to Brooklyn with the whole bus incident thing when he brought 30 people, but then be mad at the results when it turns out to be violent, because that made it seem that the UFC was condemning the violent behavior of Conor McGregor. They didn't never told him, hey, you crossing the line, Conor, relax. Chillax with your behavior and what you saying. Nah, they let it go. It was like, you know what? We use it for promotion. You know what? It's gonna be good for the fight. Guess what? Now, the incident, the riot that took place after the fight, guess what? That gave the fight way more publicity than it already had. Not like it needed it, but hey, it did. So if all promotion is good promotion, why are you mad at Khabib for being a gangster and standing up for his religion and everything he believe in? But hopefully they won't fine Khabib too much, because like I said, he attacked the team. He didn't hurt nobody but the teammates, of Conor McGregor that was talking trash, calling him a fucking Muslim rat, etc., etc. Meanwhile, the bus incident with Conor, he hurt fighters. Fighters had to pull out because they got cut when they were in the bus. So that's why he had to pay more than just a $50,000 fine after that, because he got sued by the fighters. Meanwhile, Khabib, on the other hand, who are he gonna get sued by? We know Conor ain't gonna sue to save his image. He can't be a street tough guy and suing behind doors. On the other hand, he threw some punches too. He hit Khabib teammates. It ain't like he an innocent person, like I said. So at the end of the day, the only people that's gonna be suing is the commission. And I doubt it will be too much. It shouldn't be too much. If they fine Khabib too much, then that is kind of messed up. But we'll see. Any further information, I will keep y'all updated. But if you're trying to get smarter by the minute, subscribe below. If you're trying to get dumber by the second, don't, and listen to these casual ass fans. And peace.